right now I am in New Jersey, and on my way to New York. Pick this bunch up at the in downtown New York. Doing this in a bus is, it's not as nerve-wracking as doing it in an 18-wheeler, and I've done both. Lots of people don't want to drive in New York, driving a truck or a bus, what have you. I guess it's all what you get used to. Sorry for the stopper right there in the middle. I've been trying to fix that. I can't seem to do it. So, one of the things that you learn up here is most of these folks are professional cornholers. They can honk the horn, a horn with the best of them. Sorry about that. I dropped my phone. Getting ready to go into and through the Lincoln Tunnel. Now, those that were with me earlier today will remember that somebody decided that they were going to kind of run over me in the Lincoln Tunnel this morning, and I have the marks to prove it. Flip the side of the bus in the tunnel, or right before you go in the tunnel, and then they hit it into the tunnel, and you really can't pull over right there. So we don't have these so much at home as they do here, and to go through the tunnel, it's either $14 or $24. And so there you go. On the turnpike over here, it cost us about $50. So we are we're fortunate at home not to have to deal with that. However, several of the roads here are in much better condition than the ones that we have, at home. And the tolls are part of what help them. They pay for their roads and infrastructure with tolls. God knows taxes are high enough too. I'm not going to try to take this off and put it back on, but you can see the Empire State Building from here. You can't really see the top of it because we're pretty much probably at about 250 or 300 feet socked in with fog. This morning it was something else with fog. Alright, so we're about to find out if the great folks in New York take plastic. I hope so, because that's all I got. So, let's see how it come out. Oh! Huh? No, I just bent it a little bit. It just turned it in a little bit. That's all I got. Thank you. When they built these tunnels and these toll plazas, I don't think they really had any idea that people are actually going to use large vehicles to come through here. apply here, because when they built this, I don't know, cars were smaller, or the people that built it were dumber. But I don't really think that they had in mind the amount of traffic and the size of the vehicles that were going to be coming through here. That's a Metro bus in front of us. I need some of the signs that he's got on there. He's got one that says warning don't pass on the right, and another one that says warning don't pass on the left, and caution bus swings wide all turns. What that means to drivers is absolutely nothing. I was just telling a friend of mine on the phone that the one thing that I have noticed here and a takeaway here is the people on the streets really, they need food, they need water. But the main thing that I have found, and this is not just New York, but it's that way when we've gone to Portland or New Orleans or Las Vegas or even at home in Huntsville, one of the things that people need the most are socks. The lady that's in the video that I was talking to that you may have seen when I was in D.C. had broken her ankle, and she only had socks that came up to the bottom of her foot. They were those real socks like you'd wear with tennis shoes. Well, the boot had gotten to the point on her bare ankle that had worn a sore in her ankle. And I asked her, I said, Miss Dolores, is there anything you need? She said, honey, I need socks. So we're going to try to put together a bunch of socks and come back to New York Friday, I think it is. We'll be here from Friday until Wednesday. And so we're going to try to get together some socks and practical things that they need. And I'm not sure when I'm going back to Washington. I would love to put together a mission trip to D.C. It's just, it's really eye-opening to be sitting less than a football field away from the White House and a few blocks from the Capitol, and we have veterans that are sleeping on the ground. Some of them are there by choice because they don't want to follow rules, but the majority of them are there because they have to be. They've either lost something, lost jobs. One of the ladies that we talked to out in San Antonio, her husband had died. She didn't have insurance. Her husband didn't have insurance. And she was able to stay in her house for 3 months. And then she lost it. And she was living in the streets. She had no family. She had a daughter that lived with her. And both she and her daughter were living in the streets of San Antonio. We've got homeless and gutters from Scottsboro. You name it, and they're there. And I would challenge you, as I did last week, to get outside the four walls of the church and of home and go out and meet some of these folks. A lot of them have just a story that just really will tug at your heart. And they need help. There was a study back a few years ago, and it said that most Americans were three paychecks away from being homeless. And I believe that. You know, Dave Ramsey hadn't made a living off of the Dave Ramsey Show because people plan well. He's made a living off of that show because people don't. So I would just encourage you to look around where you are and and notice the people where you're living and meet a need. It's not like there aren't needs there. I'm gonna try and get this mirror straight right quick. I think that did it.
And also, knocked the water over, but the pool needed a good cleaning anyway.
There you go. The other thing that is pretty cool to keep with you, put it in your car when you're traveling places like this, is water. You know, just grab you a case of water, throw it in your car, and it's amazing at the effect that just a fresh cup of water or a bottle of water can be to somebody. One of the things that we've learned over the years is don't bring anything real spicy, real cold, you know, cool, but not real cold. A lot of the homeless people are not, they haven't eaten in a while. So in San Antonio, a friend of mine and I bought a case of beanie wings, or not beanie wings, we probably should have, but we bought a case of Vienna sausages. And the people that we handed them to appreciated them, but a couple of them got sick from just the beanie wing, or just from the Vienna sausages, for whatever reason. It was the sausage just didn't agree with them in the heat. So peanut butter sandwiches, peanut butter it is great to bring with you on trips like me.
Okay, sounds good. All right, bye-bye. But anyway,
there's a reason they call it the city that never sleeps. You can come down here pretty much 24/7, and there's something going on. Those of you that were with me earlier today may notice there isn't the volume of people on the streets that there was earlier today. During the day when people were at work, this place is crowded. To an unbelievable level. We saw people crossing the streets, and it looked like a cattle drive. I mean, there were probably 500 people that crossed in front of us at one time. The light would change for about two and a half minutes, and you'd see this throng of people on the road, and it was just it was wild. We went through, and I didn't live stream this because it was pretty hairy where I was going, and we had the tour guide with us. I don't think I did, but we went through Little Italy and Chinatown, and I didn't realize this, but New York has the largest population of Chinese people than anywhere in the world other than China. They have moved into into Little Italy, and most of Little Italy is gone. We're coming up on the theater district. Some of these signs that you may see flashing, you'll see in the movies. Earlier today on the live feed, I showed y'all a picture of the.
Okay. All right, I'll be there in a minute. I'm at Chevy's now. So, all right, bye.